Hello everyone and welcome to my channel. My name is Claudio. So glad that you're here. If you are visiting for the first time, thank you so much for stopping by. Consider subscribing and liking this video. If you're returning, thank you as well. Today I'm going to walk you through how you can add text and graphics to your photos using Adobe Express. This is a great way to create content that you can share on social. So let's go ahead and get started. Here I am at express.adobe.com and I'll click on the plus sign to start a project. Choose the custom size graphic. And for this one, I'm going to go with the Instagram portrait size and click on next. And what I'll do now is drag in a photo from my desktop here. I'll go ahead and close this out on this side. This is a portrait that I shot in my office. And what I'm going to do is go to add to background just to increase the size. I was doing some dramatic portraits and right here I have some lining for the background. I'm going to go ahead and increase the size a bit. I'm going to show you how I can add some text here to use on social media, something that I might want to share. Maybe what I'll do is just bring it down just a tad bit here and maybe about there. So one of the first things that I'll add here to this photo is my logo, which is a graphic that I imported. If you're interested in learning more about adding logos, check out my video in the description below. I'll click on for primary logo here. And what it does, this is a signature, as I mentioned, and so I'm going to go ahead and add that. It's a great way to brand your content that you're sharing on social, especially folks that might want to use your photo and not give you credit. Well, if you have your logo, even then they might be able to remove it, but it's just something that I like to do to brand my content. And let's say I want to highlight this photo. Maybe I want to promo that I'm going to be having a photo shoot session. I can go ahead and add text here and I'll add it to the chest area of this photo. I'm going to go ahead and change this to a white. And one of my fonts that I love to use for my content is Bebas Nuo. And I'll go with the bold and I'll choose the magic alignment option and choose fit here. So this is something that I will use. One last thing here is the spacing. I like to bring that spacing down. And now I can go ahead and say something like a photo shoot coming soon. Yeah, maybe I can use this as a promo on social and put it right here. And once I'm ready, I can go ahead and download this to share on social. Now, the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to duplicate this project. You can see the original here and I'm going to double click that. I'm going to swap out this photo here. I'm going to go to upload and I'm going to show you another way to add graphics to your projects here. So let me go to my desktop and let's make sure, yep, that's the one I want to use. I'll go ahead and bring that one in. For this one, I'm going to keep this text and I'll just alter it. But what I want to do is highlight what's happening in this photo. And so what I'll do is maybe do this beauty dish because that's what this is right here. And the photo is a little bit darker. I might want to redo this and make it sure it's a little brighter. Maybe go into the enhancements here and let's not bump up contrast, but bring up a little bit of the brightness. There we go. That at least you can see that beauty dish there. So I've got the beauty dish ready to go there. Let's make sure that's set. There we go. Then what I can do is go over to shapes and bring some graphics here and I'm going to choose arrow. And what this allows me to do is all these different shapes of arrows, I can use it to point out the sections on this photo. Now, the only issue that I always run into is there's so many great options here. So I'm just gonna go with one of the first ones that I see here. And I can go ahead and resize this. I can rotate it. And obviously because I have a white text here, I'm going to change this to white. So now I can basically highlight what's happening in this photo. So what I'll do is show you a little trick here. I'm going to shift and click so I can select both of these and then go to duplicate. And then what I'll do is move this. And then what I'm going to do is type here. Let's remove that and put in camera. And then I'll just move it up a bit here. Now this arrow, the nice thing about it, you have the option to flip. I'm going to do that, flip that. And you move it up just about there. That's where the camera's at. So actually I might need to move my text down here. And one more thing that I'll do, let's make this a little bigger, is I'm going to select again. I can do these or that. This time I just did a select by dragging those, and I'll duplicate once more. And I'm going to do it right about there. I'll move this out here and maybe adjust this a bit to point out, not the photo. There we go. And just a slight adjustment here. And then what I'll do next here is replace this camera with black foam core board, because that's what I used to create this setup for that photo. So maybe what I'll do is drag that right about there. Let's make sure that that is the way it's supposed to be. Let's go back. There we go. Black foam core board. Maybe do that. And as you can see, I'm making a diagram of this photo using text and graphics, which I pulled from the shapes, which is great. You can create how-tos. You can create diagrams to point out what you are doing in a setup, or just for any type of diagram setup, you can create these types of illustrations using, again, the shapes, text, and whatnot in all of your projects here. And now you know how to add text and graphics to your photos using Adobe Express. So now go ahead and give it a try yourself. Any comments or questions about this video, drop it in the comment section below. Don't forget, hit that like button, subscribe, click the bell to be notified for future videos, and please do share this video with your friends. Thanks again for stopping by and watching this video, and as always, be good to one another. Peace.